Joining us today are political insiders Charlie Giroux on the Republican side and Mark Single filling in for Tony May on the Democratic side. Thank you, gentlemen, as always, for being here.
Our pleasure.
Thank you.
All right, another resignation in the Corbett administration. Charlie, we'll start with you. Harner resigning as education secretary. Surprise to a lot of people. Mm-hmm. The reasons behind it still kind of murky right now.
And they remain murky. And frankly, from what I know and what I think the rest of the world knows, this has to be laid at Mr. Harner's feet. The vetting process for any official in any administration is really one that begins with confession and self-disclosure. And apparently there were some aspects of Mr. Harner's past that he didn't disclose to the governor and his staff. As soon as they became known to the Corbett administration, they immediately did the right thing, asked for his resignation, and he was gone.
And the district actually released a statement saying due to privacy issues, this is a personnel matter, but any allegations against Dr. Harner during his tenure were fully investigated. At no time was he found to have violated any law, regulation, or district policy.
That may be true, but clearly there was some innuendo and there was quite a bit of gossip going mm-hmm. back and forth in the school district during his tenure. So I disagree with Charlie to a degree. I think they have to do a better job of vetting. This is not the first top official that was shown to be inadequate or with some flaws or some reason that the governor found noteworthy enough to fire or ask to resign. Mm-hmm. So I think that they've got to tighten up on their vetting process.
Either way, politically, how does it shake out for the governor?
I think this is a wash. I think people understand where the governor was on this. He was put in a very difficult position. When he was, he immediately did the right thing. It's easy to come in here and say, oh, they got to do a better job of vetting. I mean, the Democratic officials in previous administrations went to jail. These folks aren't. But the fact of the matter is, you cannot do beyond what any administration does. This isn't a policy that's unique to the Corbett administration. It is one where the vetting process begins with self-disclosure. There's no other way to start. And if folks don't tell you everything, you've got to discover it on your own. That takes time. The Corbett administration discovered this on their own. They did it before he was even sent up for confirmation. So it's no harm, no foul to the people of Pennsylvania. But the Corbett administration, and Governor Corbett in particular, did the right thing. They did it quickly. And they are, you know, putting this behind them at this point.
Well, the only thing I need to point out is this is a ninth or tenth top major official in this administration that has been fired or resigned or reassigned and so on. So, I mean, to the outsider, it looks like there's quite a bit of disarray. So I think that this has got to stop. You know, the governor's got to look like things are a little bit more secure at the helm.
All right. Well, want to move on to Syria. Major crisis going on in Syria right now. It was said today it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when the United States steps in. Is this something that needs to happen quickly?
Absolutely.
In what form?
There are four destroyers that have been positioned on the coast of Syria or in the vicinity. And I think that's a clear signal that the airstrike is imminent. I don't think it's a question of when. I think, or if. I think it's a question of when, mm-hmm. and I think it's going to be imminent.
You see the president calling for a surgical airstrike of some type against specific targets?
I do. I know there's been a lot of chatter over the last 24 hours, but Vice President Joe Biden kind of put it out there and said, look, there's no question about it. The chemical attacks came from the regime, and we're going to take them out. We're going to do something about it, and I think they're going to do surgical strikes.
It really is a question of what. I don't think it is a question of, you know, whether or not anymore. It's a question of what. And if you're simply going to lob a couple of cruise missiles in there, you're not sending the signal that this administration has to send. Unfortunately, the president went out there in the opposite of Teddy Roosevelt, you know, led with a loud voice instead of a, you know, a big stick, and said, we're going to have this bright line. You can't cross over this red line. It's happened now. There has to be a massive action in order to send the message.
Boots on the ground?
I didn't say that. I said there has to be a massive action in order for the message to be sent. This administration, unfortunately, has put us in the unfortunate position of not being taken seriously by people who want our lunch.
I can't allow it to be. If it's not our administration that has caused this, it's the administration of a monster who's killing thousands of his own citizens. So the United States has a moral obligation to assert itself. And I think we will, and I think we will appropriately.
No question that we have an obligation to assert ourselves, Governor. The question is, in what way?
Right.
Is it going to be a mild, you know, surgical strike, and then we go home, lob a couple of cruise missiles in there and say we did the job for rhetorical purposes, or are we going to go in and really send a message? And furthermore, What are we going to do next door in Egypt, where the Coptic mm-hmm. Christian community is yeah. under religious genocide attack from the Muslim community there? And unfortunately, there's too little being said about that. Interestingly, a large Coptic Christian community here in the mid-state, and I hope that we get a chance to hear from those people whose relatives and loved ones are suffering in unspeakable ways in the Middle East.
All right, we got to wrap it there. Thank you, gentlemen. Certainly all eyes on Syria and, yeah. and what's going on there. Mark, Charlie, you can catch our political insiders every Tuesday right here on CBS 21 News at 5:30.